It's a historic day for two reasons. One, for the landmark judgment by the top court of India, which upheld passive euthanasia. Two, for Rajasthan approving the bill providing the death penalty to those convicted of raping girls under the age of 12. State Home Minister Gulab Chand Kataria introduced the Criminal Laws Bill 2018 today in the Assembly, which was passed in the House by a voice vote following a debate.
हमने 12 साल से जो छोटी बच्चियां हैं उसके लिए उसी 376 क जोड़ दिया, उसमें मृत्यु दंड भी जोड़ लिया और 14 वर्ष से अधिक की सजा, और सजा होने के बाद 7 जीवन वो जेल से बाहर नहीं निकल सके, ये प्रोविजन उसमें डाला।
मध्य प्रदेश has already cleared a bill with similar provisions in December last year, while the Haryana cabinet this February gave its nod to a proposal to bring such a legislation. Maharashtra and Karnataka are also considering the death penalty for child rapists.
But it all began with Madhya Pradesh, who became the first state in India to in fact bring this law into being. And now it's the state of Rajasthan that has passed the bill, which would mean that those who are guilty, who are convicted of raping or gang raping girls under the age of 12, would in fact face the death penalty. But not just Rajasthan, many other states across the country like Haryana are also mulling bringing such legislation to curb the crimes against children and against women.
But the debate of should we have a death penalty for those who rape children still continues following a series of incidents. This also opens up the debate. Is the dialogue around death penalty taking away from action needed to guarantee child safety? Let's debate.
Good evening, voters. If you are a parent today, chances are that you're worried. You worry if your children are safe around adults they do not know, and more so around the adults they know and interact with on a daily basis. Here's why. 19,765 children were raped in 2016, and that crime graph is rising steadily. In fact, the number of cases registered in 2016 itself had gone up 82% from 2015. The fear is real, very, very real, and so is the outrage. Not surprisingly, some state governments have now enacted stricter laws to punish this unspeakable crime. First, Madhya Pradesh and now Rajasthan have made child rape punishable with death. But will that be deterrent enough? Will that keep our children safe? And in fact, that is the debate today. And in this debate, we are asking three very important questions. Question number one: should we have death penalty for those who rape children? That, of course, is the big question. Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan definitely think so. A couple of other states also do. But what about the rest of the country? When death sentence has not reduced murders, will it act as a deterrent against rape? That's question number two. Will it actually scare these beasts so much that they will think twice before touching our children? And question number three. Is the dialogue around death penalty taking away from the action that is needed to guarantee child safety in our country? Those are our three very important questions around which this debate will be fashioned. And joining us today are our panelists. Sushil Kumar Tekriwal, he's an advocate with the Supreme Court. Also joining me from Rajasthan, the state that passed that bill today, is Vibhuti Bhushan Sharma, who's the former president of the Rajasthan High Court Bar Association. I welcome both of you gentlemen to the show. We'll begin with Sushil Kumar Tekriwal. Mr. Tekriwal, what do you think? Should we in fact have death penalty for those who rape our children?
So this is certainly a welcome decision. There is no doubt about it. The manner in which the things were getting horrified and such horrendous acts were being committed, it was really going to be a very disturbing factor for all of us in the society. Certainly, the law which has been enacted by the Rajasthan is a welcome step. Two other states are following, are on the verge of following, Madhya Pradesh and Haryana. They have announced that they will be enacting the similar law. The child rapes which are taking place under the 12 years of age or 14 years of age, if such kind of situation so happens and warrants, if the and if the accused is being convicted, he has to be sent to the gallows. But we have to also understand at the same time the nitties and gritties of this law. I must say first of all, on 11th January 2016, in a writ petition filed by Supreme Court Women's Association, the Supreme Court, our present Chief Justice has categorically said that to the Parliament, saying that you have to adopt and enact a law which has to have the seriousness and stringency to curb such kind of child rapes. Now nothing happened. Parliament miserably failed in adopting and enacting such law despite the observations in 2016 being made by the Supreme Court, number one. Number two, we have also failed to today understand the juvenile jurisprudence, the criminology and the victimology aspect related to juvenile in India. So that is a very area of very serious concern. We have completely failed in understanding. Our society has not only addressed and redressed it, failed in redressing that, but also the legislature has failed. Number three, I must say one thing, the battle line which has been drawn by the state after making a necessary amendment in section 376, AA has been inserted by the state government. Now the question, the fundamental question would be that whether it would be passing the test of the judicial review, because it is not the domain of the legislature at the same time to direct the judiciary what punishment judiciary has to give. It has to suggest the way and it has to give a top line and the bottom line so far as the punishment is concerned. So will it be passing the test of the judicial review? This is third thing. Fourth thing I must say, there is also a fill in the blank so far as definition of section 372 subclause 2F is concerned, because it doesn't say about the punishment which is to be given to those people who are being involved and being convicted for child rapes. One thing more is very essential also in the same time, that today we are in a new age line of child crimes. Now we have a juveniles of 16 years old, 17 years old, 18 years old, who are committing such kind of crimes. And if suppose there is a provision of in this law that if a child rape is being taking place, definitely the death sentence will be given. So would it be applicable on those cases also where a boy of 16 right. years old,
Sushil,
17 years
Sushil
old,
Dekri, well, who that is doing that is such something kind of crime that we will discuss. Juvenile,
will he, because
right. Yes. Right, Sushil Dekriwal, we will discuss that point in the due course of the debate, but let me also bring in our other panelist, Vibhuti Kumar, Vibhuti Bhushan Sharma. I'm sorry, Sharma ji, aapka kya manna hai ki jo child rapist hote hai, jo bachchon ke saath balatkar karte hai, kya unke liye death penalty diya jana chahiye?
पहले क्वेश्चन ये उठता है कि डेथ पेनल्टी समाधान है क्या? डेथ पेनल्टी अगर समाधान है तो चीज समझ में आती है। दुनिया के 154 कंट्रीज में डेथ पेनल्टी का प्रोविजन नहीं है, ओनली 45 कंट्रीज के अंदर डेथ पेनल्टी का प्रोविजन है। और क्राइम रेशियो की अगर हम बात करें तो 154 कंट्रीज के अंदर क्राइम रेशियो उन 45 कंट्रीज से कम है। आपको सिस्टम को बिल्कुल क्राइम प्रूफ बनाना होगा बनिस्पत इसके कि आप सजा देकर डेथ पेनल्टी की सजा देकर क्राइम को कम नहीं कर सकते। मैं टेकरीवाल साहब की कुछ बातों से इत्तेफाक रखता हूं। रेप केसेस में हमने देखा है और हमारा अनुभव है कि काफी हद तक रेप केसेस पर्सनल दुश्मनी, पारिवारिक दुश्मनी, जमीन जायदाद के मामलों से जुड़े हुए होते हैं और फेक होते हैं। क्योंकि मजिस्ट्रेट के सामने 164 का बयान हो जाता है, 164 के बयान के बाद काफी हद तक रिलीफ मिलने के चांसेस एक्यूज्ड को कम होते हैं। आपको एक चीज माननी पड़ेगी कि एक्यूज्ड जब एक्यूज्ड होता है तो उसके खिलाफ पूरी सरकार लड़ती है, उसके खिलाफ पूरा सिस्टम उसके खिलाफ होता है। तो उस समय आपको देखना पड़ेगा कि एक्यूज इनोसेंट तो नहीं है किसी लेवल पे आके, क्योंकि रेप केसेस में बहुत से ऐसे मामले देखने को मिले हैं कि जहां मैं मेरा पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस है, टेकरीवाल साहब का भी रहा होगा, कि षड्यंत्र पूर्वक भी ये रेप केसेस लगाए जाते हैं, विद कंसेंट भी होता है। चूंकि 12 साल की लड़की में कंसेंट वाली बात तो नहीं आएगी, लेकिन 12 साल की लड़की और मान लीजिए लड़के की एज अबाउट 20 ईयर्स है, तो इन्फेचुएशन में भी रिलेशन बन जाते हैं, कई बात होती है, कई बार रिलेशन नहीं बनते हैं, उसके बावजूद भी रेप का आरोप लग जाता है।
जी, रेप जी, के शर्मा जी, षड्यंत्र की बात यहाँ नहीं करेंगे, यहाँ हम बच्चों की बात कर रहे हैं, बच्चों की बात कर रहे हैं। क्या आपको लगता है कि जो हैवान,
बच्चों की बात कर रहा हूँ,
जो हैवान बच्चों की बात कर रहा हूँ, बलात्कार करते हैं, क्या उनके लिए डेथ सेंटेंस सजा डेथ सेंटेंस सुनाने नहीं चाहिए?
पॉक्सो में आजीवन कारावास का प्रोविजन है और मैं सोचता हूँ पॉक्सो पर्याप्त था, मेरा ऐसा मानना है।
आपका मानना है कि पॉक्सो पर्याप्त है? सुशील टेकरीवाल, वी डू हैव अ वेरी वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग लॉ इन पॉक्सो एंड दैट इज अ पॉइंट दैट इज वेल मेड बाय विभूति भूषण शर्मा ओवर देयर। डोंट यू थिंक इट इज स्ट्रॉन्ग इनफ? इन फैक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू पॉक्सो, इफ आई एम नॉट मिस्टेकन, डिपेंडिंग ऑन द ग्रेविटी ऑफ द ऑफेंस, इट कुड लीड टू 7 to 10 ईयर्स ऑफ इम्प्रिजनमेंट और इवन life imprisonment. So isn't it effective enough?
See, number one, I must say that the death penalty provision which has been made by the legislature is absolutely a welcome decision taken by the state. I tell you, yesterday I have come across a horrific and horrendous incident which has come in the newspaper. It has been reported that a girl of 7 to 8 years old, she was playing in an amusement area of a mall, and she was being cornered by a 19-year-old person, and she was being, this horrendous act has been committed against of her. I tell you, in the last two to three decades, 700% of the rise in the child rape cases are coming. And it is when 70% of the cases goes unreported. Now you can understand the culpability, seriousness, disturbing nomenclature of this kind of child rape cases. And certainly, also we'll have to understand from the perspective of victimology. I must give you an instance. You just think that what kind of trials, tribulations, suffering, trauma a victim, a child who has been committed with, who has been a victim of this kind of incident, she must be undergoing, she must be subjecting to. Just try to understand the mental storm and mental wind she must be facing every day, every moment, every second. And this is how the things are being getting multiplied day by day. Certainly, if this kind of provision is being made, it is going to create such a fear psychosis which will certainly put a control on such kind of child rape incidents. There is no doubt about
that. That brings me to our second question, second key question of the debate, and I'll go to Sharma ji with that. Sharma ji, when death sentence has not reduced murder, hum dekhte hai ki fasi ki saza jo hai खून के मामलों में भी दिया जाता है, लेकिन उसका मतलब ये नहीं कि मर्डर कम हो रही है। तो क्या आपको लगता है, विल इट एक्ट एज अ डेटरेंट अगेंस्ट रेप?
मैं यही कहना चाह रहा हूं कि डेथ सेंटेंस के बाद क्या रेप के केसेस में कमी आएगी? मुझे नहीं लगता। 1983 के अंदर बच्चन सिंह वाला एक जजमेंट था, ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने उसमें हेल्ड किया है कि डेथ सेंटेंस रेयर ऑफ रेयरेस्ट केसेस में दिया जाना चाहिए, एक अपवाद के रूप में होना चाहिए। और बाद में श्रद्धानंद वाले जजमेंट में भी, श्रद्धानंद बनाम कर्नाटका में भी, उस बात को उन्होंने तायीद किए। आपको ये देखना पड़ेगा कि एक्चुअली दरअसल प्रॉब्लम ये है कि अभी जो विधेयक इन्होंने जो पारित किया है, उस विधेयक की पूरी तरह स्टडी की नहीं है, अभी हमने, हमारे पास आया भी नहीं है। उसको पहले तो एग्जामिन करना पड़ेगा कि उसमें क्या क्या इन्होंने प्रोविजन रखे हैं, क्या क्या अमेंडमेंट एक्चुअल अमेंडमेंट है, क्योंकि उन्होंने साथ में 14 साल की सजा का प्रोविजन भी रखा है, 14 से ज्यादा का। डेथ पेनल्टी तो बहुत रेयर ऑफ रेयरेस्ट केसेस में होगी, तो मेरा मानना है कि डेथ पेनल्टी इज नॉट ए सॉल्यूशन।
जी, आपका मानना है कि डेथ पेनल्टी से रेप्स कम नहीं होने वाली है? सुशील टेकरीवाल, डू यू थिंक इट विल नॉट एक्ट एज अ डेटरेंट? इनफैक्ट यू बीन सेइंग दैट इट विल एक्ट एज अ डेटरेंट, व्हाई डू यू थिंक सो?
See, I would like to add, first of all, I must say that as you said that there is a provision of the death penalty for the murder, it is not so. Supreme Court in various of the judgments have laid down the law saying that there will be no death penalty ipso facto for the murder, and it will be only depending upon the rarest of the rarity of the case. So therefore, the question of getting death penalty in the cases of murder, it has not proved to be a deterrent, because there is no death penalty as such today, and there is only rarest of the rare case, like in the case of genocide, in the case of big leaders assassination, there is a very conservative guideline which has been drawn by the Supreme Court very categorically. So therefore, I am saying that the death penalty categorically being enacted by the state legislature, amending the IPC Indian Penal Code accordingly, and making a stringent provision is certainly a welcome decision, and it is going to work as a deterrent, I am telling you, because you must understand also the perspective of a girl, a child rape victim who is dying every moment. What about the victimological jurisprudential concern of a girl? What we have thought of, we have never thought of a girl, we have never thought of a child who is suffering and getting subjected to such kind of trauma every moment. If you murder someone, he dies at the instance spontaneously. But a girl, a child dies every moment, every second till the death, till its natural death. So certainly it's going to be a very big trauma for a child rapist victim, and certainly we will have to enact a law, and I welcome the decision which has been taken by the legislature. It has to stand the test of the judicial review, and it's going to be a big deterrent for the people in our society, and certainly it's going to create a fear psychosis in their mind. They will think 1,000 times before committing such kind of crime and such kind of child rape issue.
Right. In fact, our viewers who are tuning in and joining the discussion also seem to be divided on either side. Ashima says, probably the perpetrators, probably the perpetrators do not have fear of law in their hearts, is what Ashima writes in. Junaid says the real solution would be to implement existing laws. Rahul says it's sickening and heart-wrenching. Such perverts should not be spared at all. So clearly, our viewers also on both sides of the divide over there. Very interesting discussion online and offline. But this also, and I would like to go to Mr. Sharma with this. Sharma ji, kya aapko lagta hai ki death penalty mein dar ye bhi rehta hai ki jab phansi ki saza sunai jati hai, wo kahin na kahin, maan lijiye jaise sessions court mein, high court mein phansi ki saza suna di gayi, वो कहीं ना कहीं वो अपील में जाते 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 इतनी इतने साल लग जाते हैं, और कहीं उन प्रेसिडेंशियल पार्डन मिल गया, वो कम्यूट हो गया, लाइफ सेंटेंस तक भी वो घट सकता है. तो इन अ सेंस डेथ पेनल्टी जो है लॉ होकर भी बहुत इफेक्टिव नहीं हो सकता है.
हाँ, मैं इस बात से सहमत हूं. अभी जो वकील साहब ने कहा उस बात से भी सहमत हूं कि लड़की बहुत ट्रोमा में गुजरती है. ये अपराध घिनौना अपराध है, अक्षम्य अपराध है, इसमें कोई संशय नहीं है. लेकिन सवाल यह है कि क्या समाधान है? क्या एक आदमी जिसको आप आजीवन कारावास दे सकते हैं, एक आदमी जिसको 14 साल की सजा दे सकते हैं? देखिए, अशोक महान जो थे वो क्रूरतम शासक रहे, बाद में उनके एक अपराध बोध हुआ और उसके बाद वो बड़े अच्छे बौद्ध भिक्षु बन गए और समाज के लिए उन्होंने बड़ा अच्छा काम किया. तो सजा का जो अर्थ है, सजा देने का जो प्रोविजन है, उसमें सुधार की गुंजाइश भी होनी चाहिए. अगर 14 साल के बाद कोई आदमी बाहर आता है, उसको गिल्टी कॉन्शियस है, तो हो सकता है समाज के लिए अच्छा काम कर जाए. इसी तरह से वाल्मीकि थे, वाल्मीकि डाकू थे, उसके बाद उन्होंने बड़ा अच्छा समाज के लिए काम किया, रामायण भी लिखी. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि एक अपराध के बाद आदमी को खत्म कर देना चाहिए, उसको डेथ पेनल्टी देकर बिल्कुल खत्म कर देना चाहिए. उसको अवसर भी मिलना चाहिए समाज में 14 साल बाद या 20 साल बाद, जो भी उसके बाद अवसर मिलना
चाहिए.
Right, Mr. Tekriwal, that's exactly what I was going to ask you. Do they deserve this kind of leniency? And secondly, is this a fear? Sharma ji, one second. So, Tekriwal sahab ko baat karne dijiye. Mr. Tekriwal, do you think that this is a fear that the death sentence could get commuted as it goes up to the higher courts?
See, we'll have to also see it from the perspective, I must say, that the law which has been enacted, that is why I said that it has to be perfect enough to pass the test of the judicial review and judicial scrutiny. And if it passes the test, because our Chief Justice in one of the case on 11th January 2016 directed the Parliament to enact a law for the child rapes, but the Parliament has miserably failed in enacting the law. But today three states have shown their positivity on this subject, and certainly this subject needs a different kind of address and redress today. I must add on one thing here. Those perpetrators who are committing such kind of crime are absolutely pervert and mentally sick, and they don't deserve any kind of leniency, and they should be hanged and sent to gallows, because they are a danger to the society, they are a danger to the law, and they cannot be rehabilitated and they cannot be reconciled. And there should not be any concept of sparing them. I must today say on record to the legislature, to the public, and also through the media, I must appeal to the Parliament today that they should immediately enact a centralized law, enacting and making applicable to all over the country, across all the states, dealing with such kind of child rapes in which any person who is a criminal being convicted has right. to be sent to gallows. Such parliamentary legislation is absolutely mandated and warranted in today's context and today's time.
Right, precisely. But Mr. Tekriwal, also let's inform our viewers here that the government of India, in fact, when speaking to the Supreme Court on behalf of the government of India, Additional Solicitor General P.S. Narasimha Rao took a stand against death penalty for child rape. In fact, he went on to say that death penalty is not an answer for everything. This was on the 1st of February 2018. So the government of India also at this point in time not really in favor of the death penalty. Mr. Sharma, aap isse sehmati rakhte hain?
Ji. Main bilkul sehmat hu.
Ji, aapse ab is
waqt mein sarkar ko kanun vyavastha
Ji, bataiye.
Sarkar ko kanun vyavastha pe zyada dhyan dena chahiye. जो एग्जिस्टिंग लॉ है पॉक्सो का, ये पर्याप्त है आज की तारीख में. रेप के अंदर भी पर्याप्त लॉ 376 के तहत भी पर्याप्त लॉ आईपीसी में है, पर्याप्त सजा का प्रोविजन है. प्रॉब्लम दूसरी है. प्रॉब्लम्स क्या है कि राजनीतिक द्वेषता, मान लीजिए मैंने ऐसे केसेस भी देखे हैं जहाँ पे गांव के अंदर सरपंचों के चुनाव होते हैं, पंचायत के चुनाव होते हैं, वहाँ पे रेप के केस लगा देते हैं अपनी बच्ची को ही इन्वॉल्व करके. ऐसे केस मैंने फेस किए हैं. तो मेरा ये मानना है कि इसका मिसयूज होगा, अल्टीमेटली मिसयूज होना है इसका.
आपका मानना है कि मिसयूज होगा. इनफैक्ट देयर इज अनदर स्कूल ऑफ थॉट, एंड दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई वुड लाइक बोथ यू जेंटलमैन टू यू नो टॉक अबाउट. द फैक्ट व्हिच बोथ ऑफ यू ऑल इनफैक्ट ब्रॉट आउट अर्लियर आल्सो, कि ज्यादातर जो इस तरह के केसेस होते हैं, जो बच्चों के साथ बलात्कार के केसेस होते हैं, वो घर ही में होते हैं, घर वाले ही करते हैं, या तो पहचान वाले करते हैं. पीपल हुम वी नो, पीपल अराउंड अस आर द परपेट्रेटर्स ऑफ दिस क्राइम इन मोस्ट केसेस. एंड देर इज अ फियर, देर इज ऑलरेडी सिवियर अंडर रिपोर्टिंग ऑफ सच केसेस. ये केसेस रिपोर्ट नहीं होती है, कंप्लेन्स दर्ज नहीं होती है. डू यू थिंक दैट ब्रिंगिंग इन डेथ पेनल्टी विल एक्चुअली एड टू द अंडर रिपोर्टिंग एज फार एज चाइल्ड रेप इज कंसर्न्ड? सुशील कुमार टेकरीवाल.
See, I am totally agreeing with you so far as the reporting of the child rape cases are concerned. Certainly, I tell you, 70%, more than 70% of the cases are absolutely being unreported, because there are various factors. There are factors of reputation, there are factors of confrontation, there are factors of fear or confrontation may get developed with the neighbors, within the family. There are factors with respect to those poverty-stricken people in the villages, in the far-flung areas where such kind of child rape cases are taking place. So certainly I must say that if such kind of demonized and satanic act, which continues to take place in perpetuity in the absence of a stringent law, it's going to rather multiply the trauma and multiply the crimes which are taking place today. There is no fear today in the mind of those demons who are being convicted for such kind of child rapes. So I must certainly say that the enactment of the new law which has taken place today is certainly going to create a fear psychosis in the far-flung areas as well, and certainly to the village areas also, and it's certainly going to create such kind of fear that they will certainly think thousands of times before committing any crime. And I must say one thing more, that the under-reporting which is taking place will certainly, this law will also be dealing with such kind of problem, and the under-reporting will certainly get wiped out to the extent possible, to some extent. I must add on one more thing. What Mr. Sharma is saying, that there are cases.
Right.
There are cases in which the child people are being falsely implicated. But those false implications which are taking place is 0.5%.
Sushil Tekriwal, 0.2 to 3%. Sushil Tekriwal, hold on to that thought.
By making an exception, an example.
Right. Hold on to that thought. One of our viewers has called in. Shrikant wants to join the conversation from Mumbai. Go on, Shrikant.
Hello.
Go on.
May I speak now?
Sure.
All right. What I feel is that on one side, the government is talking of freedom for women, upliftment and everything. Can't we think of one thing, that the girls who have to go through the trauma of facing so many things, and their family, for family life is like hell. You see, some misuse is possible. I think Vibhuti Sharma is wrong in saying one thing, that it will be misused. See, I don't think that victims who suffer, they have a frame of mind to give any false this thing. They want justice. And it's not even justice. You see that, don't you think, it's not the people, it's the, as a country, we all of us, we want justice for the people who do wrong things to the girls.
Precisely, Shrikant. Shrikant feels over here that it cannot, this is not a law that will be misused. But in fact, let me bring in Vibhuti Bhushan Sharma. आपको क्या लगता है, जिस तरह की दहशत की बात कर रहे हैं टेकरीवाल जी, क्या उस वजह से जो अंडर रिपोर्टिंग हो रही है इन क्राइम्स की, और भी ज्यादा हो सकता है क्या? अब लोग पुलिस स्टेशन में जाके क्राइम दर्ज करने के बारे में 10 बार सोचेंगे, क्योंकि हो सकता है कि उन्हीं के घर में किसी को फांसी की सजा हो जाए?
बिल्कुल हो सकता है, मैं इससे डिनाई नहीं कर रहा. अभी जो सज्जन जिन्होंने कहा कि जिन्होंने मुझे गलत बताया, देखिए मैं अपनी बात अपनी व्यवहारिक अनुभव से रख रहा हूँ, जो मैंने प्रैक्टिकल अनुभव देखे हैं. फॉल्स इम्प्लीकेशंस के केस बहुत आते हैं. टेकरीवाल साहब ने भी 5% फिगर तो माना ही है, तो 5% फिगर कोई छोटा फिगर नहीं होता है. एक भी आदमी, निर्दोष आदमी क्यों फांसी की सजा पाए, क्वेश्चन ये है. मेरी बात को तारीफ टेकरीवाल साहब ने भी की है.
नहीं, शर्मा जी, समाधान नहीं है किसी भी तरह से. कोई आपका बात सही है कि किसी निर्दोष आदमी को फांसी की सजा नहीं होनी चाहिए, पर साथ ही साथ ये भी है,
रेप
ये, जी जी बताइए.
रेप केसेस में बहुत षड्यंत्र होते हैं. रेप केसेस में हमने देखा है, झूठे बयान कराते हैं, लड़की अपनी ही बेटी को इन्वॉल्व कर दिया जाता है, उससे बयान दिला दिए जाते हैं. उसका 161 का बयान दूसरा होता है, 164 का बयान कुछ और होता है, मेडिकल रिपोर्ट कुछ और होती है, इवन कोरोबरेट नहीं करती सब चीजें. उसके बाद चूंकि 164 का बयान हो जाता है, तो कोर्ट जनरली 164 के बयान पे रिलाई करते हुए उसको पनिश करते
हैं. इस पर मैं आपसे और एक सवाल पूछूंगी, लेकिन बाबू भाई ठक्कर इस वक्त अहमदाबाद से जुड़े हैं, फोन लाइन पर हमारे दर्शक है. गो अहेड ठक्कर साहब.
हम लोग जब चर्चा करते हैं रेप की, तब हम लोग एक बात भूल जाते हैं. 2 साल पहले जब मैं इंटरनेट यूज करता था
जी,
2 साल पहले जब मैं इंटरनेट यूज करता था, तो 1 GB इंटरनेट यूज करने का मैं 150 रुपया दे रहा था. अभी मुझे 2 GB इंटरनेट सिर्फ 10 रुपये में मिल रहा है.
जी, आप कहना क्या चाहते हैं?
मेरा जो खर्चा है वो इतना कम हो गया है, उसकी वजह से गांव-गांव में जो पोर्नोग्राफी देखना चालू हो गया है. 2 GB मेरे पास है, मुझे 10 रुपया ही खर्चा करना है. वो पोर्नोग्राफी जो देखना चालू हुआ है, इसकी वजह से ये बच्चों का रेप बढ़ रहा है।
जी जी जी
तो
जी.
ये टेक्नोलॉजी का जो एडवांसमेंट है उसकी एडवर्स इफेक्ट की वजह से ये चाइल्ड रेपिस बढ़ रहे हैं। तो पहले उसका जो मूलभूत कारण है वो पोर्नोग्राफी जो ज्यादा दिख रही है उसको जब तक बंद नहीं करवाएंगे तब तक आप चाहे डेथ पेनल्टी दे दो उसको 10 बार मार डालो फिर भी वो काम करेगा ही करेगा, वो छोड़ेगा नहीं।
Right.
तो इसका जो रूट है वो रूट को आप निकालो पहले, उसके सिवा कुछ नहीं होगा। डेथ पेनल्टी दो, वो जिस टाइम पे उसका उसके दिमाग में आ गया मुझे रेप करना है तब उसके सामने कोई डेथ पेनल्टी कुछ नहीं दिखाई देता है उसको।
जी वेरी गुड पॉइंट मिस्टर ठक्कर, एंड इन फैक्ट यू हैव गिवन मी द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू ब्रिंग इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 इन दिस डिबेट, एंड दैट इज द डायलॉग अराउंड डेथ पेनल्टी टेकिंग अवे फ्रॉम द एक्शन that is needed to guarantee child safety, action like what Mr. Thakkar was actually talking about. Sharma ji.
Ji.
Ji Sharma ji, kya aapko lagta hai ki jo death penalty ki baatein ho rahi hai, jo phansi ki saza ki baat ho rahi hai, usse kahin na kahin jo sarkare hain jo action leni chahiye bachchon ko surakshit karne ke liye us action se mukar rahi hai?
बिल्कुल सही, आपने जो ये पॉइंट उठाया बिल्कुल सही पॉइंट है। पॉलिटिकल माइलेज लेने के लिए सरकार ने अभी ये निर्णय लिया है, चूंकि सामने चुनाव है, अपराध की व्यवस्था राजस्थान के अंदर बहुत ज़्यादा खराब है, पिछले कुछ सालों में अपराध बहुत ज़्यादा घटित हुआ है राजस्थान में और सरकार उसको रोकने के लिए पूरी तरह नाकाम रही है। तो सरकार के पास कोई चारा नहीं था, सरकार ने सोचा कि एक शगुफा छोड़ दीजिए, ये एक तरीका है, लेकिन अल्टीमेटली इससे क्राइम कम होने वाला नहीं है। क्राइम आपको लॉ एंड ऑर्डर व्यवस्था मेंटेन रखनी पड़ेगी, आपके पास जुडिशरी सिस्टम को मैनेज करना पड़ेगा, जजेस की कमी है, हाई कोर्ट में 50 जजेस की स्ट्रेंथ है जहाँ पे ओनली 33 जजेस वर्क कर रहे हैं, जुडिशियल मजिस्ट्रेट की पोस्ट खाली है, पीपी के पास प्रॉपर संसाधन नहीं है जो पब्लिक प्रोसिक्यूटर्स होते हैं, इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग एजेंसीज प्रॉपर अपना काम नहीं कर रही है, FSL रिपोर्ट्स वगैरह टाइम पे आ नहीं पाती हैं, 1000 समस्याएं हैं। उन समस्याओं के समाधान की तरफ सरकार ध्यान नहीं देती और इस तरह के प्रोपेगेंडा और इस तरह के इश्यूज उठा के अपने आप को बचाने का प्रयास कर रही है।
राइट सुशील टेकरीवाल, लास्ट वर्ड टू यू।
सी आई मस्ट से वन थिंग दैट आई डोंट एग्री विद मिस्टर शर्मा सेइंग दैट इट्स ए पॉलिटिकल जिमिक, इट कुड बी according to him that there is some political compulsions for which this kind of law is being enacted. I totally disagree with this. I just want to add on one thing, the last word. Today what has happened is we are all only and only thinking from the perspective of criminology. A person who is committing the crime, a person who is being convicted, we are thinking for his welfare, his rehabilitation and his well-beingness. We are not thinking today from the perspective of victimology. What has happened to the victim? What kind of trauma and tribulation one victim has faced and would be facing in perpetuity till his or her death. So this is what we are lagging behind and lagging behind. This is for the first time this law has been enacted so serious, so stringent, in which the victimology, jurisprudential science of a victim is being taken into consideration while enacting the law. I don't see any politics in this, but although I see that there is a vision, there is a different kind of vision to handle such kind
right.
of child rape cases, which
right,
are on
Sushi
high
Jadriwal.
Rise today, and certainly it's a welcome decision
welcome
from my
decision,
side being
right,
a, being a
right.
legal person.
And in fact, that brings us to an end of this debate. Death penalty at best always stirs up strong emotions, but here's where we stand. We believe that convicted child rapists must hang. This is an unspeakable, heinous crime. But we also believe that at the same time, there's a lot that needs to be done to make our cities, our country safer for children and for women. For instance, let's make an online public database of convicted rapists. Let's also make sex education mandatory in schools. These are the things that will make our cities and our country safer for our children. Thank you for watching.